Everybody, it's Matt with Mikey Designs. Today we're going to show you how to coat a screen with your scoop cutter. This screen has been reclaimed. It's nice and clean, free of dust. And we have our scoop cutter here, ready to coat the screen. And so you want to start with the print side first. I'm going to use the sharp edge of the scoop cutter, because this is a 305 mesh. Generally with higher mesh screens, we'll use a sharp edge. For something that's a lower mesh, maybe 156, 110, we'll use the round edge over here. But we're gonna use the sharp edge today. And so what we're gonna do is we're going to lean up the scoop cutter until the emulsion meets the mesh. And then you just wanna give it a nice firm pull. And then lean your scoop cutter back, let it flow back into the coater. And then this one's fairly important. Just rotate it 180 degrees. What that will do is allow it to bite into it, the mesh really well. So that way you can get some nice detail. What we're gonna do with these screens are some CMYK process printing. And what I just did was I did another pass on the inside of the frame, pushing all the emulsion down to the bottom. And so now we're going to go ahead and set this in our screen rack. And you'll notice, I don't know if you can see here, but but you'll notice, I don't know if you can see this, but you can see that there's a nice smooth coat to it. And generally, I like to use the one-in-one method. Generally for shorter runs, that will last just fine if you're doing longer runs, or if you plan on keeping a screen around that's going to be used for thousands of prints, I would recommend letting that dry and then coming back and using the round edge to put a second coat on the bottom and letting that dry again. We're going to do one more screen just to demonstrate it one more time. Here we go. So print side first, let the emulsion flow to the mesh, and the emulsion's not running out, so it's firmly placed on there. With these screens here, you don't want to press too firm, otherwise you can pop your screen, but you generally kind of want a little bit of a zipping sound whenever you're coating your screens. So here we go, on the inkwell side, or the print side, this is your garment side over here. And so now we're going to set this in a rack, and that's pretty much it.